There's this scene in the movie Arrival where Jeremy Renner's character, who's a scientist, is brought in to try to help the military deal with alien spaceships that have landed across the globe. And in an early version of the script, he asks if the aliens have responded to Fourier series sent out by the humans. Problem is, that wasn't exactly the right math reference.
Well, a Fourier series is a mathematical concept, but it's not like a series of numbers. So I changed that to Fibonacci series, which is in fact a series of numbers that aliens might actually send to us as a way of getting our attention.
Phil is an astronomer and a science blogger, and he's also part of the Science and Entertainment Exchange, an organization that connects creators in Hollywood with scientist script advisors. They set up a phone number for screenwriters like Arrival's Eric Heiserer, who want their scientific references to sound right.
Here's one of the things that I wanted to make sure to do with this movie, and that's not to be embarrassed about complicated ideas, not to be embarrassed or ashamed of hard science, that, you know, these are the words and the terms that people in this position would be sharing with each other.
Phil's advice to use Fibonacci added that extra bit of credibility.
And, you know, I didn't really think much of that, but then, you know, I went to go see the movie, and Jeremy Renner actually says that.
You know, have they responded to anything? The shapes, patterns, numbers, Fibonacci?
And I'm nudging my wife, like, yeah, pointing the screen, pointing at me. It's like, yeah, he said what I wrote. That's so cool.
There's a lot of really bad science in TV and movies.
I'm getting hacked!
There's bad computer science, bad geology, bad physics. So in 2008, the Office of Communications at the National Academy of Sciences launched the Science and Entertainment Exchange. Here's how it works. You call the number, you describe your question, and then the team filters through their database of 2,400 scientists and engineers to put you in touch with the right person. They estimate that they've done between 1,700 and 1,800 consultations since they started. That includes almost every Marvel movie and 2 2017 Oscar nominees. A lot of times, the consultation boils down to changing a line to include a scientific concept. In early discussions for the 2011 Thor movie, producer Kevin Feige needed a way to represent the rainbow bridge that reaches between Earth and the realm of the gods in Norse mythology. So he met with Sean Carroll, a physics professor who later paraphrased their conversation in a blog post. Carroll suggested they describe the bridge as a wormhole. Feige didn't want to do that because it sounded too 90s.
And he said, well, there is this thing called the Einstein-Rosen bridge. Einstein-Rosen bridge? What is that?
Einstein-Rosen bridge is the technical term for a wormhole.
And they said, we love Einstein-Rosen bridge.
Listen to the dialogue in the movie and you can hear where they added in the concept of an Einstein-Rosen bridge.
An Einstein-Rosen bridge is a theoretical connection between two different points of space.
The wormhole.
But the team's focus isn't just about what characters are saying, it's also about who is saying them. In the original Thor comics, Natalie Portman's character, Jane Foster, is a nurse. The physics professor who consulted the filmmakers argued that it would make more sense for the plot if she was a physicist studying the wormhole that brought Thor to Earth. And for the exchange, that sounded like the perfect opportunity to break down gender stereotypes.
We love nurses, but we also really love the idea of a strong female character who is an astrophysicist.
So the writers changed it.
You're an astrophysicist, not some storm chaser.
I'm telling you, there's a connection.
2 years later, that character was the focal point of a contest hosted by Marvel and the Science and Entertainment Exchange, where young women interested in STEM careers could interview female scientists in the exchange's database for a chance to tour laboratories and film sets.
We are very concerned with the way that scientists are portrayed on screen. You know, we want them to be, I mean, you always want them to be the hero, right? That's the best thing. And a main character is fantastic. But we want to see women. We want to see people of color. And we want to see them woven into the fabric of the everyday life that you see on screen.
Since 1983, repeated studies have shown that when children are asked to draw a scientist, they overwhelmingly draw old white men. Children usually cite film or cartoon characters as their main source of inspiration. And in the original research, children drew these stereotypical characteristics more and more frequently as they grew older. Science has had another image issue in Hollywood too. A survey of over 1,000 horror movies distributed in Britain between 1931 and 1984 found that scientists and their work were the villains of 41% of films. Scientists were the heroes less than 1% of the time. In the decades since then, perceptions of science have gotten better. An analysis of over 3,000 interviews on public opinion about scientists found that American adults in 2001 were much less likely to hold negative stereotypes about scientists than they were in 1983. And they were much more likely to believe that a science career was a good choice for their children or for themselves.
I mean, people do learn from film and television, whether you want them to or not. We often refer to it as an accidental curriculum.
One of the most talked about examples of that is what's called the CSI effect, the idea that chart-topping crime shows increased interest in forensic science, but also spread a lot of misinformation about the field.
CSI didn't just launch a franchise, it created a false impression when it comes to solving crimes.
Researchers in 2010 found that watching the show is associated with perceptions of DNA evidence as much more reliable than it actually is. The Exchange wants to mobilize that kind of effect, and hopefully make science more understandable and more accessible for everyone.